So on to the wild asparagus. Wild asparagus is a beautiful, delicious, delicious vegetable. Now is the season for it. We're in the middle of 20th, almost the end of May. And fiddlehead season is almost done. Asparagus season is starting. And these are the purple variety. And you can see they're not all the same because they're wild, right? But they're all very good, very juicy. We prepare them a little differently than, well, actually almost identical to the fiddleheads, but we boil them, only blanch them for about 1 minute or less in the hot water. And we have to make sure we remove all the critters. You see the little baby snail there? Yeah. So I'm going to take that outside and put it on a leaf somewhere. I'm not going to kill it. Poor thing is just trying to eat. And then I'll see you when I wash some of these and get them ready. So here we are, we washed some of our asparagus. Beautiful asparagus, they're amazing. Just gonna blanch them for about a minute. Water was already boiling, don't worry. Look at that, oh, they're gorgeous. A minute and a half. And then take them out of the water and cook them away. Very simple. So let that boil. Once it reaches boil, about a minute, minute and a half, and then we'll strain them and I'll be back then. So we let our asparagus, wild asparagus, boil for about a minute and a half. I'm gonna turn it off, maybe 2 minutes, strain it, and I'll be right back. That's fantastic. I didn't take the end pieces off, I don't need to. Most of them are still very, very tender and easy to eat. If one or two are not, well, it's okay, we'll find out one with you. So I'm just gonna add some butter here to my pan that I just used for the fiddlehead. Gonna use a little more butter for my asparagus. Asparagus and butter go well together. A little bit more olive oil. There. Same thing, same thing. Again, we could pickle these asparagus, but they're gonna be weird and stringy and mushy, and I'd prefer them like this. I might try to pickle a couple of jars, but I'll see, I'll think about it. So let these brown a bit. So my onion, chopped onion and garlic is browning, and with some olive oil and butter in there, I'm gonna add a little more drop of olive oil, just a little bit. And I'm gonna start putting my asparagus in. Not trying to be fancy or anything, all the hot. Simple, natural food that is very delicious. Easy to eat, easy to prepare, and straight out of nature. I'll just dump that in there. A little salt. And of course some black pepper. I love black pepper, especially fresh ground black pepper is the best. Toss it a bit, make sure it's all covered. There we go. And don't make a mess on your clothes like I do. There. And this is almost done. And does not look beautiful. And believe me, it's gonna taste fantastic. Voila. Oil that's been infused with the garlic and onion flavor, the butter, the black peppers, a pinch of salt, and more salt, yummy. And this dish, if you want to call it that, is done. I put this on a plate and I'm gonna try it. Here we go. And again, do everything like I'm doing, just leave out the mess. And the most amazing, the most delicious vegetable, beautiful, fresh, wild asparagus. I just have to taste it. You know what? I just want a little piece here. It's okay, I'll take this one. Look at that. Wow. So fresh, but so tender at the same time. Easy to eat. The bottom is a bit fibrous, but still good. Oh, this is so good. Yummy. Again, please do give this a try. It's worth it. You will love it, I promise. Do like, subscribe, and share our videos. And stay safe and healthy. Until next time, bye for now. See you soon.